treating Omicron, some antibody therapies work, others not so well. The number of mutations carried by the Omicron variant surface a lot of concerns, especially in the effectiveness of existing COVID-19 treatments. To shed some light, a new study revealed that many antivirals are less effective against Omicron compared to other variants. Mutations can go either way for viruses. They can either improve their abilities to spread disease or reduce their chances of becoming a problem. In Omicron's cases, the mutations appeared focused on transmission. However, it doesn't mean the variant could easily be affected by existing treatments. Obviously, current vaccines couldn't perfectly shield people from catching the coronavirus. They are more effective in preventing hospitalization, severe symptoms, complications, and untimely death. COVID-19 treatments like monoclonal antibodies are available. These are designed at labs and mimic what natural antibodies can do: bind to a specific virus and stop it from attaching and infecting healthy cells. Since these lab-based antibodies share similarities with natural ones, they are also vulnerable to viral mutations. Any major changes in the physical structure of the target virus will likely impact the effectiveness of monoclonal antibodies. So, Omicron's mutations matter in treating patients who got sick by the variant. Published in the New England Journal of Medicine as co-respondents, tests were conducted on 7 monoclonal antibodies therapies to determine if any could hinder COVID-19 variants like Beta, Gamma, and Omicron. Results are quite worrying because monoclonal antibodies are expensive to begin with. While they may be offered cheaply or even free right now, charging patients will eventually come. The author noted that etesevimab couldn't neutralize Beta, Gamma, and Omicron variants even at the highest value tested. Bamlanivimab worked against Beta and Gamma yet failed against Omicron. Imdevimab demonstrated very high activity against Beta and Gamma, though lost the fight versus Omicron. Casirivimab performed well with neutralizing activity across 3 variants. Tixagevimab, cilgavimab, and sotrovimab showed activity as well against 3 variants. Of 7 drugs, only 4 were found with better chances at battling Beta, Gamma, and Omicron. This indicated that some monoclonal antibody drugs need tweaking to overcome the mutations. Dr. Stuart Turville, a virologist at the University of New South Wales, told Medical News Today why sotrovimab seemed better than casirivimab. He said, "Whilst many developed antibodies have great potency towards previous variants, the changes in the spike glycoprotein rendered them ineffective. Sotrovimab binds to a conserved site that persists in Omicron, so its activity is largely retained." Dr. Rajesh Gandhi at Massachusetts General Hospital also confirmed that sotrovimab continues to be active against Omicron in lab studies. Are you aware that such therapies exist for COVID-19? Did you know someone who received such therapy because of this disease? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.